Pranayama part, I think we are clear. I'm clear in terms of what needs to occur there. Of course, I need to get initiated from you. And
yes.
The part that
yes.
you talked about is the jhana and the samadhi part. And is jhana, is there anything special technique we need to learn? Is it something, because unless we do the meditation, the combination of these two will work better. But I'm only
yes.
hearing the pranayama part, but not the meditation part. Is the meditation part is the evolution in this process, or how is that being done?
Yes. Okay. What type of pranayama you are doing?
In fact, I'm not doing any pranayama, but I usually
okay.
do the anulom vilom part of it. But that's 3 times a day. When possible. But what I'm hearing from you is, once we get initiated from you by
yes.
this pranayama technique,
yes.
face to face, we also need to do the meditation, right? We only are churning the milk or the buttermilk at that point, but
oh,
we're
okay,
not getting...
Okay. I got it. Yes, I got it.
Thank you.
See, after getting initiated, you do pranayama initially. Actually, there is no time limit for doing pranayama. But after doing for some time, you stop doing pranayama and simply look upward and observe. Don't do any pranayama. Let the mind go anywhere. But while doing pranayama, you will get divine light that is evolved out of pranayama. That will be collected while doing meditation. For doing meditation, there is no technique. For doing meditation, there is no technique. Technique is with the pranayama only. Simply, after stopping this pranayama, you simply keep quiet and look upwards. That is called meditation. While doing that meditation, the divine light that has evolved out during pranayama, that will be collected in the center of the in Brahmajyam. So the very purpose of doing meditation is to collect the divine light. The very purpose of doing meditation is to collect. Ah, yes, thank you.